In a recent video, I explained how to use the pen tool in Affinity Photo to create an accurate mask of this building. If you watched that video, you may have noticed a problem with the mask I drew. Let's magnify the image to 200% so I can show you. If I hide the sky layer, you can see that there's still part of the original sky at the top of the building. But that isn't the only problem. When I move down the right side of the building, there's another small area of original sky that's become visible. Let me show you how to fix these problems and improve the quality of your masks and selections. Now, usually when editing a mask in Affinity Photo, there's an option to refine the mask. But when I right-click on this mask, we don't see it in the pop-up menu. That's because this mask isn't a pixel mask, as I drew it using the pen tool. This created a series of precise curves which are just mathematical shapes rather than pixels in a mask. The benefit of this type of mask is that you can continue to change and refine the curves. Watch what happens when I click on the node tool in the tools palette. You can still see the nodes or points that I originally drew to create this selection. I can then click and drag them with my mouse to reposition them. I can also change the shape of those curves, which allows me to fix this problem. Unfortunately, this doesn't help me remove the unwanted sky. Let me now show you two ways you can do that. The first is using the pen tool again. Before I do anything though, I need to select the mask I want to modify in the Layers Studio panel. Then when I select the pen tool, I can see the nodes that make up that mask. Last time I drew around the building which removed the sky from the image. To remove the other areas of sky from this mask, I only need to draw around them again. But there's an easy mistake to make if you're not familiar with the tool. Watch what happens when I try selecting the section of unwanted sky. It creates a new curved vector mask, rather than removing the section from the original mask. Let's undo that now by pressing Command and Z on a Mac, which is Control and Z on a Windows PC. The mistake I made was forgetting to click this icon in the Pen Tools toolbar before I started drawing. This icon causes any new curves that I draw to be added to the existing vector mask. Now I can draw the new selection like I did in the previous video. I'll then drag the curves into position using the node tool. You can already see that the checked pattern is displayed through the building in the area that I selected, showing that it's now transparent. Let's select the node tool and I'll use that to drag the lines into position to create a precise mask. I can now continue and select the next area to remove that from the image and repeat the process. If you give me a few seconds, I'll just finish the rest. Now earlier I said that there were two ways that I could fix this mask. The first was using the pen tool, which we've already looked at, but the second way is using the Refine Mask feature in Affinity Photo. I know I said earlier that that wasn't available, but that's because we were working with a vector mask. The solution is to first convert the vector mask into a regular pixel mask by rasterizing it. The downside is that rasterizing the mask will destroy the nodes, so I won't be able to change them again. I'll therefore first duplicate my mask in case something goes wrong. I'll right-click the mask in the Layers Studio panel and then in the pop-up menu choose the duplicate option. Let's turn off the original mask so that we can now see what's happening when we work with the duplicate. I can then right-click on the duplicate mask and select the Rasterize to Mask option in the menu. This converts it from vector curves to pixels, which we can then edit using the Refine Mask command. Now when I right-click on the mask thumbnail again, I can see the Refine Mask command. Clicking this opens the Refine Mask dialog, and we can see the masked out area in red. Now I can use the controls and tools in the dialog to remove the unwanted sky by painting it out. These tools are extremely powerful, so you need to watch this video next to understand exactly how they work. Thanks for watching today, and if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you soon for another video.